Hello, and welcome to 5 a Day with Jay. Helps to turn on the microphone. You know, I'm having one of those days. Work. I work in cybersecurity. I also do some development with the work that I do. And I got stuck on a query today that I just could not get to work. I don't know why. I spelled the name of the column correctly. I would run another query with that same column name. It would run fine. My insert query would fail. You know, it's... Eventually, I went to another developer, and he and I looked at it, and everything looked fine. He rewrote it. His didn't run properly. He ran it, worked fine. I ran it, didn't work. Sometimes things just don't work, and I felt like I was beating my head against the wall. It was one of those times I needed to just step back, take a breath, walk away for a minute. I went downstairs, came back up, looked at it, and I was missing a semicolon. I've been developing professionally for 20 plus years. I actually began coding when I was 12 years old. Still, when I code, I'll miss a semicolon. And actually, it wanted to be two different things. One was the semicolon. One was I was missing a closing brace, closing bracket, closing parenthesis, whatever you want to call it. It's times like that that it's really easy for me to get frustrated. And then it's just like, oh, once you see it, it's like, wow, really, really, that's all it was. I eventually got the query working in the database, put it into my code, failed in my code because of the missing parenthesis. Got it working. Everything worked perfect. I had somebody else test it. It failed for them, but it worked for me and the other developer, the other person testing. It didn't work. And it's like, okay, let's see what's going on. So I watch him perform the task and it works. No explanation why, but all of a sudden, hey, it worked. These things happen when I'm writing as well. I'll be plugging along. I'll get to a point when I'm writing and I'll get stuck and I can't figure out why I'm stuck. That's not happening with my writing right now. By the way, sorry about the hair today. But that is happening with getting everything ready to publish. I know the process. I know what needs to be done. I'm going through the motions. I'm double checking everything, making sure that everything is right, tight, and ready to go. And I'm ready for this big launch. I got all of the short stories and anthologies assembled and together. I even got the fourth one started because I have half of those stories already done. So I'm excited to get that going. I'm excited to get back to working on Giant Robot Planetary Competition Book 3 that I'm currently writing. But I want to get all of the books currently ready to start pumping them out and get them flowing. I'm excited to do that. I'm excited to get the fresh edits into the existing books that are out there, V&A Shipping 1 and 2 and Giant Robot Planetary Competition Book 3. And it's overwhelming. It's a little overwhelming. And again, much like with the coding, getting overwhelmed, I just need to step back. Step back, take a breath, breathe, deflate. I will be working on getting the books. This evening I'll be doing some more work on the books. Tomorrow, I'll be working on getting the books ready to go. I need to get the ebooks done first. That's my main goal, getting the ebooks ready to go. Then I'll upload the print book so I can get the exact cover dimension, so I can adjust the cover and the spine exactly as it needs to be, so I can make sure that when it's printed correctly and looks clean, so it doesn't get rejected. All of these things I have in my head. I've done them before, but it has been, I want to say, at least 5 years since I published anything. Again, my loss of readership is all my fault. I get that. I take 100% of the responsibility for that. Right now, it's the time for me to, as I said, take a deep breath and get ready because I know what's coming. I know that this push of dropping content every single week since I know a lot of people aren't watching these videos and aren't reading the blog, it's going to be a complete shock and a surprise when the content just starts rolling out. And it's just going to be boom, boom, every Wednesday, every Wednesday, every Wednesday. More content, another thing, print book, ebook, short story, boom, boom. I'm excited for it. I need to get the audiobooks recorded and get those going. As I said, it's easy to get overwhelmed. And I'm at that point right now where it's not that I'm overwhelmed as much as anxiety, fear, excitement. It's all boiling up at the same time. And I know I need to just deflate and get away. Going to take care of that. I'm still doing the workout, still doing the self-care, taking care of myself, doing my workouts. I've got a bike that I need to fix. Going to go for a bike ride tomorrow. I'm kind of excited to do that. I haven't ridden a bike in public in I don't know how long. Outside of the big four-seaters that you ride out there on Coronado Island, we've done that before. But it's been a long time since I've just been on a bike and went for a ride. That's the kind of stuff I need to do to just clear my head. And I also enjoy... I spend all day sitting at that laptop. I spend a great deal of time sitting at this computer. Obviously, with the coronavirus and everything else happening, getting out isn't really that much of an option, but we're going to go... All of us are going to go to a park. I can't walk on flat, hard surfaces. That seems to really stress my knees more than when the missus and I go for a hike. Can't go... We're not going for a hike. So... The missus is going to go for a walk. My favorite daughter and hijo, they're going to go running. I'm going to ride the bike. It'll be a good time. It'll be a good time. Tomorrow, get out and get some fresh air, get some vitamin D. Even though this window, I get all kinds of sunlight all day long. It's going to be good to get out and just recharge the batteries for a few hours. And again, like I said, I'm going to come back here. That said, Short Story Saturday, as I've said, is on hiatus for the time being. The Friday Fiction on hiatus until I can get all of these books ready to go. I will probably do a 5-a-day with Jay because I want content every single day going out. I want a YouTube video popping up every single day. Why? Because I don't want to start slipping and missing things. I might get some time lapses together to put up on YouTube. I GoPro's sitting right there, pointed out the window. There's some great shots of some night skies, some incredible clouds happening, lots of birds in the tree, beautiful sunrises with the clouds. I love when the skies change. So I might put a bunch of those together and get an extended time lapse up on YouTube. I've been doing TikToks, which are just 1 minute long, but having fun with those. I keep thinking about the Murdoch Minute, and I think I'm going to drop the Murdoch Minute because of the fact that I've got so many other things going on that it's hard to keep everything straight in my head. I would love to start doing book reviews and whatnot before. I do need to reach out, and hey, Mike Plusdead, if you're listening, I'm going to be giving you a call soon. I want to reach out to my co-author, Mike Plusdead, and see if he's interested in doing something collaboratively together. A video. Half an hour a week. He and I just, as authors, talking. What have we been doing? What are we up to? That type of thing. Not so much getting caught up, but almost like a weekly podcast, video cast type of thing. And I would do it as a podcast, do it as a vidcast, and it'd be fun to get it out there. I've got another site that I'm looking at where I can take the audio from these videos and upload the audio as a podcast. I've been out of the podcast community for a significantly long time. I've lost touch with many of the main players. Back in the day, it was a very small, tight-knit community, and I knew everybody. Time has changed. Things have moved on. This happens. This is life. I'm kind of interested to see what happens getting back into the podcasting arena and just check it out and see what goes on. Maybe I'll attract an audience over there doing this daily podcast that I'm doing, 5 a day with Jay. Again, as we've talked before, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Sometimes I run a little long. But I'm having fun doing these. That's the whole point. I'm having fun sitting down, recording every day, and talking. And it helps me get my head straight and get my head clear. Like right now, I've had this few minutes that we've been talking to deflate from the anxiety I was feeling and not wanting to sit down and start editing these books because I know how much work it's going to be. I know how much time it's going to take to do the formatting, to do the layout, to do get the edits incorporated. I know how much work it is, and that's for one book. I've got 4 books that are done, 3 books that are already published that I need to get the editing into those books. I've changed a couple of pages so that I've got all of my links instead of listing all the books. A whole lot is changing in the interior, and I need to update the webpage. I need to get the covers on the webpage. Again, I've got a list. I need to start checking things off. But that's why I do these videos, is to kind of, sometimes things pop up like, oh wait, because I just forgot about updating the website. I need to go add that to my list and make sure that gets accomplished. A lot of little things that I need to do and I need to make sure happen in a timely fashion. At any rate, I want to thank you for joining this evening. It's been 5 Day with Jay. I've been Jay. You've been awesome. Leave me a comment. Tell me what you're working on. What is it you've got going on? Do you have anxiety or fear about getting it out there into the public? And what are people going to think about it? Let me know. I'd love to hear from you. You know how to contact me. All the information is down in the show notes. Until next time. Stay awesome.